the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate. Good morning, viewers. Or maybe no viewers. Let's see. Who cares either way? Ultimately, I'm doing this for myself so that I can look back on this and say, this is where I came from. Okay, here's the deal. The one that I have at title. We have a contractor going down at 8:45 this morning, which is in like an hour and some now. Maybe even an hour. I don't know what time it is. But yeah, so we got a contractor going to check it out. So I'm going to get the word today on whether or not if this guy is going to buy the deal or flop on the deal. And if he flops on the deal, then I lose my money. But hey, $180 EMD is really not bad to lose.
Okay, you see this right here where it says get two properties under contract?
This is a prime example of the law of attraction. Let's look at it.
You see that? That's two properties on one contract, but it's still technically get two properties under contract. Law of attraction works in funny ways. You gotta be very clear with what you want.
I'm actually uploading vlog number one right now. So there's gonna be about a 2-day buffer, I'm thinking, so that I have time to like edit and all this stuff. I'm gonna try and pump out one a day for a little bit. But after that, I'm going to probably have to stop pumping out one a day or hire out the editor so that it's easier to do all my regular stuff. You know, I got a life. I got to work towards my goals. You know, I was thinking yesterday, even though I've had success in my business, and I mean, I'm currently having success, and before I had success, I was thinking, I'll probably be happy once I have success. Now, I'm not saying I'm not happy, but yesterday, after I finished shooting the video, I got really upset, really overwhelmed, kind of angry. And I was thinking, like, what the fuck? Like, I've accomplished... Well, I mean, I haven't accomplished my biggest goal, but I've accomplished one of the small starting points goals. Why am I angry? And I was really mind boggled. And I guess what I learned from it is that it's not really success that makes you happy. It's not the external things that make you happy. It's you that makes you happy. You decide if you want to be happy. You know, TVs, brand new iPhones, fucking money, all that shit, it's not gonna make you happy. Like, I just got a new iPhone, but at first when I got it, you know, it was amazing. I was like, wow, this is so cool, I love it. But now I'm used to it, and you know, like, it's not that great anymore. I'm used to it. I appreciate the fact that I got it, but, you know, I've become adapted to it. I've become used to it, and now I don't appreciate it so much. So, let me ask you this. What is it that you're really wanting in this world? Is it money, cars, women or men? Is it what? Or is it just happiness that you're wanting in this world? Maybe satisfaction, to be satisfied with what you've accomplished in life. It's a hell of a question. Ask yourself it now. So I'm doing my meditation here, and I come to the realization most people are on a constant pursuit of happiness
And I'm thinking to myself, like, fuck, when I get my Tesla Model X, will I be happy? Maybe for a moment, but I won't be fulfilled. And then I want to get more. And then say I get a Ferrari. Will I be happy? Maybe for a moment, but will I be fulfilled? I'll want to get more. And, like, really, it comes down to this thing that I showed you guys earlier. You know, if you put your happiness in temporary things, your happiness is going to be temporary. So what really would be the solution to that? I guess I would have to figure that one out. Maybe just choose to be happy and not let things make you happy. Let you make you happy. All right, we're going at it again. Back to the park. Gonna get some reading time in. I don't know why people don't like dandelions. I think they're quite beautiful. Do, do, do. Don't get hit. Don't trespass. The violators will be dumped and prostituted. Nobody falling in there. There's clowns down there. I guess this is what I really needed to hear right now. Listen to this. Assume control for everything. I was going to call this chapter Don't Be a Little Bitch, but I decided to back off a bit so as to not offend anyone, and I've been trying to work it in the title since. Crybabies, whiners, and victims don't do well at attracting or creating success. It's not even that they aren't capable, it's just that people who typically succeed are required to take big actions, and it is impossible to take big actions if you don't take responsibility. It is equally impossible to do something positive when you're spending your time making excuses. Okay, so seller just showed up at the property, 8:40 a.m. There was no contractor there. Contractor was supposed to be there. I called the buyer of the property. And at first it started ringing, and then on the second dial, it wasn't ringing anymore. So I think he got cold feet, and he doesn't want to buy it anymore because of the foundation issues. I think he's scared. We'll see what was going on with that. My reputation really took a big blow there. I put my faith in this guy, and maybe I shouldn't have. But hey, you know. It's a good lesson learned.
Is that you'll get motivated, you'll get inspired, and that'll just be a declining arc for a few minutes after you listen to this video that ends with you doing nothing. And what I want, what I really hope for, and the reason that I give myself over to making these so complete, can become the greatest of all time. And once you have that faith, once you know that simply being a human being puts you in this rare category of creature that can get better through pressure, through pain.
Okay. We got some relieving news.
Another person is interested in the Elkhart property, the one that I've been having all this trouble with, been on a really tight schedule with. She says that she is going to go by the property at 1 o'clock today. It's 10:44 a.m. Whew! She says also the foundation problem is not as scary as people think it is. She's willing to take on a project like that. She runs a construction team. So what her big concern is the neighborhood. She wants to make sure that it's a nice neighborhood. I'm praying to God that it's a nice neighborhood because I just want to get this deal sold very badly. My pride is on the line. I don't want to lose my pride. Yeah, so let's make it happen.
We have a little buyer's package of all the photos and stuff, the numbers on the property. Blah, blah, blah. Now I'm going to start marketing this property. And we got 347 text messages to weed through. But most of them are just this auto reply bullshit, like this one right here. There's many of these, which is annoying.
Well, after climbing all the way down there, I realized it's not as beautiful as I thought it would be. It's a little dingy and gross. There's lots of garbage around. But that lady got back to me about inspecting the property. It's actually 12:30, so she got back to me early. She says that she doesn't want to buy it. The roof's falling in. There's the foundation problem and all that stuff. She thinks that it wouldn't be worth it to buy it. It's a bulldozed property. So, I guess I've lost $180. But I learned a lot. It's not that big of a deal that I lost. You know, we fail our way forward. You can't win if you don't risk failing. Like, fuck, somebody said to me, you know, you're never gonna roll six if you don't roll the dice. But here's my little addition to that. Your chips get reloaded every single day. You get new energy every single day. So you can go all in every single day. And yeah, you might not roll six. But if you just keep going all in every single fucking day, one of these days, you're gonna roll six while you're going all in. And that's gonna be a big reward.